Good morning. It's Tuesday, August 16th, 2022. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for your journey today. Our devotion today is entitled, When Darkness Seeks to Overcome the Light. And our scripture is Isaiah's Prophecy, chapter 66. This is what the Lord says, Heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Could you build me a temple as good as that? Could you build me such a resting place? My hands have made both heaven and earth. They and everything in them are mine. I, the Lord, have spoken. There's a huge difference between wisdom and knowledge, even though they're often mistaken for one another. For instance, memorizing the entire Bible is not an evil thing. Rather, it's putting quite a bit of good, useful knowledge in your head. On the other hand, quoting that scripture, even verbatim, to a wooden chair is not only an exercise in futility, but it's quite dumb. It's anything but wisdom. King David wanted to build God a temple, and God said, Really? Now, it wasn't a bad thing for David to want to do something for God, but God preferred David to have the perspective of reality. Any quote-unquote house David could have made for God as a home would come from the limited perspective of a man's imagination. When it comes to the wisdom of the universe, we humans have little of God's knowledge, wisdom, and ability. God created everything, seen and unseen. He is above creation, even time and space. God is unlimited in everything, so who in all humanity could design and construct a house for God? That's like darkness trying to instruct the light how to unveil truth. It's the height of absurdity. We humans have always been rather puffed up. Paul warned about that in his letter to the Corinthian church, 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 12, If you think you're standing strong, be careful not to fall. That is a solid heads up for people like me. I like to plan out everything, mainly because I don't like surprises. I want to know where we're going, how long it's going to take to get there, if we've got enough gas, and will we have to stop for meals, and who's paying for what, and on and on. God says, come on with me, I want to show you something. Russell would want to see an itinerary, complete with pins dropped on the GPS and four or five alternate routes, and God often says to Russell, really? For you today, if you've got your day all planned out, daytime or stuffed with 15-minute segments of stuff that you're going to do, it might be a good thing to check in with the Creator of time. When our plans begin to become more important than being still and listening to the one who puts breath in our lungs, it's time to put those plans on the altar. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.